in a severe case of the disorder, that is uremia, the patient has to go through dialysis, right? Means purifying the blood. And this is done through this artificial kidney, and the process is known as hemodialysis, right? Hema means blood, dia means through, and lyo means to separate. So hemodialysis is the process by which the toxic components from the blood, they are removed, and this is done in severe disorder of the kidney, that is uremia. That is uremia, right? So what is the machine? The machine is known as hemodialyzer. It is known as hemodialyzer. So let's see what is actually hemodialysis. How will you define hemodialysis? It is a process of diffusion across a semi-permeable membrane. And this semi-permeable membrane is used as this cellophane membrane. We use semi-permeable membrane. The example is cellophane membrane, which allows only a few components to pass through it, right? So a process of diffusion across a semi-permeable membrane to remove unwanted substances, the toxic substances you can say, from the blood while adding desirable components. So this is what do we mean by hemodialysis. Means we are removing the toxic components from the blood artificially by this artificial kidney. And one very important interesting information for you is that this machine, this process, it was discovered by Dr. Belding H. Scribner. So he was the first one to actually discover such a process of artificial kidney which can be used, this machine hemodialyzer, which can be used to actually get rid of the toxic component from the blood whose kidneys are not actually working very well. So this was a very big achievement by Dr. Belding. And let's see how this artificial kidney actually works. Well, here from the patient, this radial artery from the patient is connected to the tube of the artificial kidney machine, this hemodialyzer. And this radial artery has the blood that contains a toxic waste, right? And what are these toxic waste? It contains urea, uric acid, creatinine and some mineral ions. And with this, it also contains what? It also contains your blood cells. With the blood cells, it also contains plasma proteins. So this is what is there in your blood, which comes from this radial artery and enters to this tube. And there is a pump out here which is going to push this blood to this cellophane tube, right? So in this cellophane tube, what is going to happen? The cellophane tube is going to contain the blood that is containing the toxic components as well. That is going to contain urea, uric acid, creatinine, mineral ions. But with this, it also contains blood cells and plasma proteins. Now this tube, which is the cellophane tube, it is actually impermeable to the blood cells and the plasma proteins. Means the blood cells and the plasma proteins are not going to diffuse out. But only the pore size of the cellophane tube is going to allow urea, uric acid, creatinine and some mineral ions to actually diffuse out. So they're going to diffuse out in this dialyzing fluid. So this is a chamber which is containing this cellophane tube, right? And through the cellophane tube, the blood is going to flow and the toxic components that we don't need, that is urea, uric acid, creatinine and mineral ions, they're going to diffuse out in the dialysing fluid, and this dialysing fluid is going to be collected over here. So in the cellophane tube, now we have the blood that is actually not having these toxic components, that is urea, uric acid, creatinine and mineral ions. So this dialysing fluid is going to be going to come here and collected in this chamber, and through the radial vein, the purified blood is going to enter into the patient's body again. So this is how the hemodialysis actually works. This hemodialyzer, which actually cleans your blood, which removes toxic components from your blood, this is how it is going to work. So remember that the radial artery is connected to the tube, and with the help of this pump, the blood actually flows through the cellophane tube, which is a tube which is semi-permeable, right? It allows only selected components to pass through it. So it is impermeable to what? It is impermeable to the blood cells and the plasma protein. They are not going to go out, diffuse out. But the components such as urea, uric acid, creatine, mineralize, these molecules are going to diffuse out. So one very important you can say feature of this cellophane tube is that the plasma proteins are not going to get lost. So they will be there in your blood, only the toxic components are going to be removed. So the blood that is now free of these toxins is sent back to the patient's body through this radial vein, right? So this is how the process of hemodialysis actually works in case of patients who are suffering from severe uremia. Around 500 ml of the blood can actually pass through one time, and in case of severe uremia patients, this hemodialysis is carried for 3 times a week. For 3 times a week, and this process at one time takes approximately 6 hours. This process takes approximately 6 hours, right? Now let us see how this artificial kidney is there and how this hemodialysis process is you can just see how this tube is attached with the artery of the patient, that is the radial artery, and how the toxic blood, you know, containing toxins, the toxins are removed and we have the filtered blood which is returned back to the patient, right? The purified blood which does not contain any toxic component. So this is how in the hospitals you see a hemodialyzer, that is the artificial kidney commonly known as, right? So this is the way by which the uremia patients who are suffering from this disorder are treated, in which you can see the toxic components are removed, that is uric acid, urea, creatinine and some mineralites, and the purified blood is sent back to the patient's body through the radial vein, as we have seen in this image also. So this used dialyzing solution is returned to this chamber, right? Then this is under observation, right? So this process takes around 500 ml of the blood, right, at one time, and it is done 3 times a week in case of severe uremia patients, and this process takes approximately 6 hours, right? So the uremia can be treated by this artificial kidney by the process that we call as hemodialysis, and the machine that we call as a hemodialyzer. So thanks to Dr. Belding S. Scribner, who has actually given a hope to the severe uremia patients.